Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I appreciate everyone who's with us this morning on this. I believe it's a very important issue. Domestic terrorism, from domestic and foreign terrorism, is an important issue, no matter whether you're a veteran or not. And I think also having information and data to have this hearing is equally important. In my understanding, as we really don't have much data to go from on this hearing, you know, in terms of the number of vets who were arrested on January 6th, I've seen figures and testimony from 40 to 70, a very wide swing there. It's no secret that there are criminals looking to prey on unsuspecting internet users, including our veterans. Nowadays, it seems everyone is at risk of disinformation, of identity theft, scam, and fraud spread on the internet and social media. But despite all of these well-known threats, there are many individuals who are not armed with the proper knowledge to make informed decisions about what they are consuming, clicking, and liking and reading online. That's why Ranking Member Boss and I introduced HR 2326, the Veterans Cyber Risk Awareness Act. This bill would direct the VA in coordination with other experts to create an outreach campaign to educate veterans about cyber risks. Today's hearing has made it clear that we do lack crucial data and information to determine whether veterans are actually more vulnerable or less vulnerable than others, civilians, and how many veterans are actually participating in violent extremist groups. We lack all of this information, a lot of this information and data. This lack of data is why our legislation would require an independent study on veterans' vulnerability to cyber risks, resources to assist vets in combating cyber risks, and the effectiveness of such a this type of outreach campaign. This bill is supported by the Disabled American Veterans, Veterans of Foreign Wars, Student Veterans of America, Paralyzed Veterans of America, and the Wounded Warrior Project. And just last week, Mr. Mervan allowed me to speak on this bill, and I appreciate that opportunity. I hope that the overwhelming support we're receiving will lead to the bill's inclusion in our next full committee markup. It's very clear to me today that we lack data on this issue. So I have a couple of questions in the remaining time that I have. My first one is for Mr. Butler. Despite the widespread support of the VSO community, IAVA has yet to support this bill. So I'd like to ask you if you support HR 2326.
Thank you, ma'am. I look forward to hearing more about it from your office. I'm sure my leadership in D.C. is probably connected to your office on this. I don't know enough about it right now to tell you, but I definitely can assure you that we will check out the merits of it and give you a thumbs up or thumbs down. And if it is a thumbs down, we'll tell you exactly why. So I look forward to hearing more about it.
Yeah, I would love that. We need as much support as we can get. And I think, you know, seeing that there is such a lack of data, and Dr. Jones, I appreciate you being here today. And I know in your testimony, your comments, that you're going to present data to us. But to my knowledge, there hasn't. I heard a lot of anecdotes, but I did not hear a lot of data. And to make informed decisions about policy, I do think it's really important to have data to go from. And my understanding, I think your testimony said there were 66 vets that were arrested on January 6th. Is that what your data kind of said?
Our data looks at the number of plots and attacks. So there are a number of indications that there were roughly 66, but yes, that's correct.
Okay. And you said in your testimony that there, although the number of veterans that are involved in domestic terrorism type of attacks or violent attacks, the number is low, but the percentage has gone up. Have you compared that percentage to the cases of violent acts by groups like Black Lives Matter, Antifa, anti-fascist, fascists? What is the difference? Have attacks of the by those individuals also gone up at the same rate as veterans, or gone up at a higher rate?
Well, again, what we see between 2015 and 2020 is that 10% of all domestic terrorist attacks and plots were committed by veterans. I mean, there's various time that has
what
gone by.
What percentage of violent attacks and domestic terrorism attacks have been committed in the last 2 years by Antifa or Black Lives Matter?
What we found in 2020, for example, is that anarchists, anti-fascists, violent environmentalists, and others perpetrated 23% of terrorist attacks and plots. Yes.
Okay.
Those numbers have gone up as well.
Yeah. And I heard you understand you work with the FBI, the DHS, and DOD. Did you know the FBI doesn't even track Antifa cases? And there have been hundreds of acts of violence and domestic terrorism across the country, not just on January 6th, but over the last year and a half, including at my home in Charleston, South Carolina. So I appreciate all of your time today, and I hope that we can get more data to make good, better, more well-informed decisions to help our veterans in the future. Thank you, and I yield back.